Previously on AMC's The Walking Dead.
Worth.
Previously on AMC's The Walking Dead.
I can't leave. I can't join the fight.
Enid!
I'm gonna be in charge of your very own outpost.
Right.
See, I need my bullet maker making bullets.
Don't matter if the big man ain't here. He could very well be back.
Laura. He picked up Laura.
Carl's dead.
He wrote letters. He wrote one to you. He
wrote one to you. Dear Dodd. Take care of GDF, man. Dodd, take care of GDF.
I remember my 8th birthday at the KCC with that giant cake and Aunt Evie showing up on leave, surprising all of us. I remember Mom. I remember Codger. I remember school. And going to the movies and Friday night pizza and cartoons and Grandma and Grandpa and church. Those summer barbecues and the kiddie pool you got me. Could have used that in prison. You told me about the walks we'd take when I was 3. You holding my hand around the neighborhood all the way to Ross's farm. I didn't know that I remembered them, but I do. Because I see the sun and the corn and that cow that walked up to the fence and looked me in the eye. And you told me about all that stuff, but it isn't just that stuff, it's how I felt. Holding your hand, I felt happy and special. I felt safe. I thought growing up was about getting a job and maybe a family,
nope.
Being an adult, but
nope.
Growing up is making yourself and the people you love safe. As safe as you can, because things happen. They happened before. You were shot before things went bad. It kind of felt like things went bad because you were shot. I want to make you feel safe, Dad. I want you to feel like I felt when you held my hand. To feel that way for 5 minutes. I'd give anything to make you feel that way now. I wanted to kill Negan. I wish I did. Maybe it would have been done. I don't think it's done now. You were not there again, but I don't think they surrendered. I don't think they will surrender. There are workers in there, Dad. They're just regular people. Old people, young people, families. You don't want them to die, Dad. We're so close to starting everything over, and we have friends now. It's that bigger world Jesus talked about. The kingdom, the hilltop, there's gotta be more places. More people out there, a chance for everything to change and keep changing. Everyone giving everyone the opportunity to have a life, a real life. So if they won't end it, you have to. You have to give them the way out. You have to find peace with Negan. Find a way forward somehow. We don't have to forget what happened, but you can make it so that it won't happen again. That nobody has to live this way. That every life is worth something. Start everything over. Show everyone that they can be safe again without killing. That it can feel safe again. That it can go back to being birthdays and school and jobs and even Friday night pizza somehow. And walks with a dad and a 3-year-old holding hands. Make that come back, Dad. And go on those walks with Judith. I shall remember them. I love you, Carl.
Michelle, Okoye. gonna move on, people. Got somewhere to be. I gotta go. Got somewhere to be. I gotta go.
You will be torn apart.
Fear. Clear. Morgan Jones.
I came back here to make amends.
Same.
You made me look like an ass.
Bitch.
My intel wasn't current, you know. Things changed at Alexandria. Juice. Juice and momentum can change the game. They had it. They did it. Margaret had the hilltop by the nut. I didn't know it. And yes, we paid a price. But let me make it right with Negan. I'm Negan. And not in a collective, we're all Negan sense. I have assumed control of the Saviors. Negan is no longer on the field of play. You're the man now? I am. I knew it. I knew you could do it. Negan was a big personality, I get it, but too unconventional. Pulled his punches.
Exactly.
It's a mission.
You are the kind of man people can look at and say, now, there is a leader.
Which is why I can't be seen going easy on you. Optics.
You don't have to worry about optics now.
Oh, I know. I have that juice. I have that momentum. I want to keep it. Ergo, you go.
Well, that is just breathlessly stupid. You think these troglodytes here are going to advise you in managing communities? In resource reallocations? In politics? That's right. Yeah, the bare-knuckle nad-mash of politics?
Never it politics.
It's ended, Gregory.
No! I've achieved too much. I've suffered too much. I've survived too much for it to end like this. I've lost myself to the vow. Seen through the storm, and I have been reborn as a certified shit kicker. I make things happen. I've always made things happen. And it's not going to end with me wandering off into the wilderness with my dick in my hand. I put things together when everything fell apart. And I can do it again. I will do it again. Who the hell are you to tell me I'm done? You think you have the juice? Well, I am the juice.
Ooh. Look at him bleeding like a bitch.
First, I wasn't going to send you away. I was going to kill you. Second, do you make coffee?
Best in the land.
I'll start with coffee and see where it goes.
He's still out here. Didn't see him when we left. Maybe he finally gave up. Nope, he won't. Not unless we make him. We should just kill him. I got it.
Hey, Ron.
Told ya. Has he eaten? We made our choice. He wants to die in the woods, hoping we change our minds. That's his choice. Find yourself some water.
Big head bitch.
Seems like a waste of good garlic to me. And everything else.
A sardine mac and cheese recipe I gave you was a staple from my college days when, as a
cash-strapped student. I had to pad out the budget, mind goodness, of Emmett powdered C with the protein power of canned sardines, which provided a longer lasting energy source than pure carbohydrates. The garlic saute alley is what originated as a purely oops dish.
Fat boy.
Checking my back.
Checking my back.
Start plating it up. This is all that's on the menu for the rest of the time until this quarter's complete.
Fat boy.
I'd like to remind everyone that our lives are not on lock. Out of personal respect of the mutual nature with Negan. But Negan is MIA.
Father Gabriel.
Simon has taken over and he has requested an exponential acceleration of production. More shots on the liggety quick. Even if we're double timing it around the clock with an area of carry for workplace safety, it isn't going to prevent us from meeting our quixotic quota by the proverbial crack ton. The best that we can hope for is that we somehow manage to squeeze out the bare minimum number of rounds necessary to avoid the consequences of Simon finding out how short we are. For yours truly to contract whatever kind of nasty infected you with your improper gut handling. My current theory is that it's either influenza or cryptococcosis and therefore airborne. If it was of the blood variety, you would have already been dead. But the fact remains, you're packing pathogens that can sting with a sneeze, making it imperative that you maintain your PPE at all times while your meds run their course. Now hold out your hand. Aren't flush. The finished rounds pose a deadly risk of slam firing as soon as they're loaded into the chamber. Given that this imperfection is readily evident to the touch, I can only assume that this oversight was purely intentional.
No. I didn't know. I just wanted to make it so that the bullets didn't work. I wasn't trying to hurt anyone. I don't want any of my people to die.
If you cannot accept to wear your people now, you may as well cut to the chase and chew the next bullet coming off that line. Is that what you want?
No. That's not what I want. I don't want that. I don't want to help you. But I do fear death. We all this, maybe this is just his way of showing me that I haven't changed. A way of showing me that I'm still the same person who locked my parishioners out so long ago. Still the same scared animal doing what I must to survive, just like you.
Being alive may be something we don't have in common for much longer. You are hereby suspended from the line. Find an unobtrusive corner and stow your load. Keep your mitts to yourself.
Sick ass. Move it now.
Try not to cry too loud. I'm gonna go outside and test fire some of these rounds that you didn't compromise with your chicanery.
Chicanery. You're not about Milwaukee. Oh! Oh! Rosita and Daryl. God damn, that was fast. Woo! Shit! Damn! That was quick. Whoa! I am not Ashley. Deacon's back.
Surprised to see you, mate.
Surprised to see me.
Shouldn't be.
Got Laura with me now.
Hell yeah, I'm surprised. We found your car and Simon thought...
Give me a hand with this, will you?
Not gonna lie.
Real punch in the dick when Rick cornered me in the basement with those decomposing assholes you fellas have showed up. Simon, I want to know what you were thinking. See, I want to know if you remember who you are. This little talk is just between me and you.
Simon's your number two. I thought you wanted him calling it. I remember who I am. I'm Negan.
Good. That's what I like to hear. But do me a favor. Put that smoke out. Right there. See, when the time comes, and you will know when it comes, I want you to remember this little talk. I want you to remember what we've done and what we can still do together.
Where's Laura?
I've got to call the pool cleaners or...
Shut up. John Legend. No one came to hear you speak. People keep calling to me, dog. Grandfather called me. But my mother answered the phone. I ain't answering that shit. Hope it's cold tomorrow. Hope it's cold Monday. My stomach is full. Come on, man. Oh, shit. Damn, she looked good. Hold the fuck up. I'm going to have to record this on screen capture. She looks very nice.
Player one, rated PG-13, now playing.
I thought they killed you. And that you were gone, like... like that. I lack discipline. And I made it personal. And that's why I moved things from infection to extermination at the hilltop. Yes.
What do you say?
And that's why I moved things from infection to extermination at the hilltop. Yes. Things went bad. Though I think it's possible we may have found ourselves in a similar tactical situation regardless of approach. We don't know that. So I'll own it. I just ask that you give me a pass on this one.
No pass.
I'll make it up to you. I promise you that.
Really?
You know, I remember when I took this place. When you helped me take this place. I wasn't sure I wanted to keep you on board.
Jada said everything.
Before me, before there was a system in place. What you did, killing all those men, those boys in that settlement so long ago. A lot of people would think that is some psychotic. psychotic shit. Like, that is the work of a demented, broken, goddamn ghoul. Like, that's not someone that you want to work with, let alone stand next to. So I figured I'd keep my eye on you. And I did. And everything seemed to work out right up until this point. I'm gonna need you on your knees.
Ooh. Damn, Simon. You're dead. Hurry up. Chop, chop, Trevor Phillips looking motherfucker.
Every time one of them tries to poke their head out, sometimes right in front, sometimes from a mile away, but every goddamn time. Tomorrow afternoon, I am going to take a 10-head team to this spot. I am stocking it with supplies and ammo that Dr. Smarty Pants are making. Everyone else here can do the same thing, same time. Different spot. In the day tomorrow, we will have cache after cache around that hilltop and always be spitting distance from a reload. There will be teams 24/7 around that place, sniping them one by one, day after day, until we have full attrition. It's an ambitious plan with testicular heft. I'll give you that. Very happy to have you back, boss man. Damn, good to be back. All right, everybody clear out. Except for you, Dwight. Got a few things we need to kick around.
Now you, Dwight. You kill your own people.
You are smart as hell, you know that?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, after everything, Sherry, a sizzle. You didn't stew, you didn't do anything stupid. You just went about the business of getting yours. Nothing shook you. You kept your eyes on what could keep you alive and well.
Hey, I didn't know that T.C. Carson. Kratos is T.C. Carson. I didn't know that. That's dope.
Kratos, God of War.
crazy, son. Eugene, jogando na Transplanning, tudo.
I can't help but suspect that the reason I'm being taken alive is, despite what completely warranted bad blood exists between us, you still harbor a vestigial nostalgia for our erstwhile camaraderie. And in light of that, I'm willing to just shut my grub flap and give you your space until you see such a time as you're ready to break the ice. One train will come.
Cut your mouth. If I cut your tongue out.
Cut your tongue out. Tongue out.
Gotta keep going. You do. You're looking for him by now.
Scared ass.
Thank you.
Shut up.
Yeah. Hey, bitch. Folks like me, bitch. Such a bitch. Bitch, bitch, bitch.
When I told Negan I made the bullet, it was to save your life. I didn't think. I just acted on your behalf. And I fully expected the crack of the bat to be the last thing I heard, but that didn't happen. And then I thought they would torture me. But they didn't. They gave me a chance to live. And I tried to resist. I tried to rise above my biological imperative, but that is not who I am.
I know who you are. You're the reason they were able to escape the sanctuary. Everything that's happened since then, everyone who's died, and that's on you.
Rick's the one who pushed us all to take the Saviors home. He's the one who jumped headlong into this shitstorm with no waiters.
You turned your back on the only friends you ever had. Shooting you in the head right here would actually make the world a better place. We're not gonna kill you, not because we give a rat's ass about you. We just need what's in there. We're gonna stick you in the darkest hole we can find. And the only time you'll see the light of day is when we need you to teach us how to do something. So don't worry, you'll get what you want, you'll live. But we're gonna force you to do something useful with your pathetic life.
You engaged in activities said management would frown on.
Show feels weird.
So this is it. You deliver or get shipped. He hasn't delivered. And that saddens me. But the time has come. Let us gather our like-minded individuals, draw strength from each other,
and kill Negan,
and do what we need to do. Gotta selfless to you? Think about everything he's done to you. Every little indignity. Everything he's extracted from you. Think about it. Don't you know what you have to do? You have to meet us in the courtyard after rounds and we begin what's next. I mean, Jesus, right? Right. Yes, my boy. Yes.
Pregnant bitches. Can't blow a whistle. Oh, he vomited. Ew. He nasty. Ew. Nigga, man. He just rolled all over.
He couldn't have got far. Come on.
We can't let him get back to them. If you see him, blow that pig's head off.
Oh, that's smart. Head right under the bullshit. Cranium, boy. It's behind you, man. You're moving too fast. Get you a stick, man. There you go. Gonna bite your fingers, boy. Kick that bitch, man. It's your weak ass.
busy yet?
It's their fault. You hide. You don't trust. You don't live the life the way you want to because of them. They hurt you. They're gonna keep on hurting you. Unless you do one thing. Fight.
Machete, we back. Red machete. Through the back lines. Daniel Wu. Where is Laura?
Hey.
Hey.
Shit, huh?
Yeah.
I think you wanted this before we did.
All of them when Negan did it. All of them. Look at them. All these motherfuckers trying to kill Negan.
If you're here right now, you're in. We can talk about approaches and finesses, but you are in. No take backs. We need to make this quick, quiet, and respectful. Man's done a lot for us. He deserves that.
Sound him up and down. He's setting his ass up.
You have some legitimate personal issues with the man. The kill is yours if you want it. Something quiet. I mean, not a knife. Can't make it that personal. A silencer? We call a meeting. And that's it. The next order of business is to set the break to start the healing. The catalyzing event to facilitate that is the destruction of the hilltop, and its residents will make it a monument of compliance. Sorry, Gregory.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll get on with our lives. Right, Dwight?
Whitey boy. Yep. Simon's dead. Simon is totally dead. Damn.
Oh, thank you, Dave.
Damn, Simon dead.
I'll take it from here.
Simon is dead as fuck. Gave you a chance, nigga.
3, 2, 1.
Oh, shit. Who did that? The Rock. And the other guy. Damn. Gotta weed them snakes out, man. Simon is dead as fuck. Everybody got
Simon. There is the Simon that I know. Comes right at you instead of that backstabbing bullshit. Why? After everything he did to you, huh? Why?
He's loyal.
Do this? He'd win.
Killed all the garbage people, Simon.
After I specifically told you not to do that shit.
Yep. I should kill one.
But after all this and me being me, he's still gonna give you your shit.
Still? Negan's being lenient.
You want to be the man, you gotta beat the man.
Oh, bare knuckle, bro.
You can do that.
Bare knuckle.
Hell. You should be the man.
They better throw hands, man. Too? He gonna beat the shit out of Simon.
Everyone!
Nigga's an athlete.
After this is done, we get to work.
You talking trash?
Just know that I didn't want this. But the sanctuary must stand. This is not the man to prosecute this conflict. Just wanted to say a grateful enclave.
Ooh, backhander. Cheap shot. Damn.
Asshole.
on Friday the 13th.
Yeah, I'll see that movie. It looks pretty good. Truth or Dare. Truth or Dare. Over there. Truth or Dare. Truth or Dare. Truth. Oh, here we go.
Some kind of dickless worm planning on killing me. Like, what else am I gonna do besides crush the guy's throat? Yeah. You know what's bad for Simon? It's good for you. I know we've had our ups and downs, D, but I've always been able to count on you.
Where's Long?
So, congratulations. You are my new right-hand man. That is, if you accept the promotion. I do. And I'll help you finish this thing with Rick. Don't sell yourself short, D. You already have.
Laura.
Oh, there she go! Woo! There she go!
Yep. Fucked up. Damn, Dwight.
Well, you look surprised, Dwight.
Here she go.
Yeah, I see. I found her on the side of the road. Laura, why don't you tell Dee what you told me?
That night in Alexandria, he turned on us. He killed our team. I ran, and I kept on running. I was hurt. But what kept me alive was the thought of getting back here and exposing you for the scum weasel you are.
Damn.
It all makes sense now. You told Rick when to attack. How to get to the outpost. You help keep us locked in here, slipping them workers' guns. I mean, maybe you even lied to me about killing Sherry. Oh, hell, you for sure lied to me about that. So what? You think you're some sort of a hero? No, you are nothing. A nobody and way over your head. But when I said that you would come through for me when I needed it, oh, I meant that 110%. See, I knew that I could count on you to deliver my plan to Rick. My brilliant, if I do say so myself, fake-ass plan. You use Gregory for that, right? I mean, I was thinking maybe you'd take some kind of field trip or something, but oh, you got yourself a little delivery boy. Good for you. To deliver all that intel to Rick and the piss patrol that's gonna lead them directly into the line of fire. They are not gonna know what hit them. All thanks to my new right-hand man.
Damn, Dwight.
Now see, I thought about killing you, and then I thought maybe that'd be too dignified for a backstabbing, double-crossing dirtbag such as yourself. Oh, Dwighty boy, I got plans for you.
Eugene, dirty as shit.
What the hell happened?
We
operations to defend this place in case of another incursion.
We've established a perimeter. We just got a message from the sanctuary. Negan's back, and he has plans to finish the hilltop. Rick's walking into a trap. We'll need the bullet order filled by tomorrow morning.
Looking beat to Negan, my personal congratulations on the occasion of his return, and assure him that his request will be fulfilled in its entirety and on time. That's right. If Negan needs bullets to end this war, then by ginger, he's gonna get them. All of them. Scotch my talk of a bare minimum. No sirs and madams. We shall rise to the occasion with the ammunition. We will blow them away with every trigger pull they require. We shall. We will. Oh, trip now, colleagues. We will change Sager history evermore. Gabriel. It's all hands on deck. Yours are sorting shells. Listen, you follow my lead to the letter on the lead, or you can cry and die. Here we go. Time to do something useful with our pathetic lives.
Look at him. Oh, that's some nuts.
Why don't you put him on?
This isn't about Rick. It's about Carl.
He wrote you a letter. And I'm delivering it because that's what he wanted.
Well, I can't promise not to kill the messenger.
Just shut up and listen. Negan, this is Carl.
I was helping someone. I got bit. We didn't even have to be doing what we were doing. I was just helping someone, and now I'm gone. You might be gone. Maybe my dad made your people give you up and he killed you, but I don't think so. I think you're still around, and you're working on a way out. Maybe you got out. Maybe you think we're a lost cause and you just want to kill all of us.
I think you have to be who you are. I just wonder if this is what you wanted. I wanted to ask you.
I wish I could have.
Maybe you'll beat us. And if you do, there'll just be someone else to fight. The way out is working together. It's forgiveness. Believing that it doesn't have to be a fight anymore. Because it doesn't. I hope my dad offers you peace. I hope you take it. I hope everything can change. It did for me. Start over.
You still can.
There is no getting out of it now. I wouldn't accept your surrender if you came to me on your knees. See, winning isn't about beating you. Winning is about killing every last one of you. That is starting over. I never wanted this. Rick made this happen. You tell him that. No more talk.
Ooh. Finna bust a move or what, my nigga? What you gonna do?
That was tight.